So last night, Variety posted a story that there's an actress supposedly in talks with Lucasfilm to take the lead role in the show the NPCs really want, The Acolyte. Considering the fact that if you go onto IMDb Pro, and I went and actually got a subscription so I could actually look at it, eyes on target, if you know what I mean, look at the evidence myself, there's no movement. It hasn't been any movement in a year. The Acolyte is a product of what looks like a frenetic attempt to get stuff up for Disney Plus and to make. And basically, a bunch of shows were announced last year at the Investors Day in December 2020. One of them was The Acolyte. Now, we had heard about this. We knew that Kennedy had basically done a development deal with a woman who's coming up next to make this show called The Acolyte. But there were a lot of other shows. I mean, if you look, there were at least 10. And the only ones we know for sure that are in development, that are being made, are The Book of Boba Fett, which is coming out at the end of December. Obi-Wan Kenobi, which is done. It's coming out next year sometime. Andor, which is coming out next year sometime. And Ahsoka, we were supposed to get Rangers of the New Republic. Of course, Kennedy attacked it in Empire magazine, saying that, well, those stories are going to be put into other shows. You know, she doesn't know what she's talking about. All right, she, as far as I can tell by looking at IMDb Pro, nothing belonging to Star Wars is under her purview anymore. Okay. But you'd have to know that. Now, there are people out there in the Phantom Menace, bigger channels, angry fanboy rage porn addicts who see her name as president of Lucasfilm. And immediately, they don't think. They follow the surface. They're just like the NPCs. They've become what they hate. Their ability to think critically is non-existent. Okay. So, and one of the shows, of course, was The Acolyte. And every once in a while, we hear stuff about it. But when you look at the IMDb Pro page, there's nothing been listed since a year ago tomorrow. All right, a year ago tomorrow. So let's talk about what could be happening with this, basically what looks like to me a PR war. Leslie Headland, Harvey Weinstein's former assistant. What secrets is she keeping and what does she know? And maybe she's got a criminal past with her harassment herself. I mean, look at that face. Break a rock. She's the showrunner, not the director. You can be a showrunner and a director, but she's never been a director of this show that is called The Acolyte. And it was like, when we heard about it, back I think in March of 2020, we all groaned in anger and frustration. Okay, but Leslie Headland has a very interesting and colorful past. This is Harvey Weinstein. Of course, we all know who he is. He's a pig, a predator, a rapist, a sexual deviant who would use his position to get beautiful women, force beautiful actresses to sleep with him. And knowing personal assistants the way I know them in Hollywood, I actually dated a movie studio head. That's a long story. He's Italian. And I had a row with his personal assistant because she was disgusting. And I mean, basically, she's the one that basically said, made me think, I can't do this. I don't tolerate women behaving like pigs, and she was a pig. But, you know, he would have his personal assistant meet these girls in the lobby, hotel. The idiots would take them up to their room, and Harvey would assault them. Leslie Headland was one of those assistants. And I wouldn't doubt she's got a Me Too in her background, too. But this is her background. So this is the woman Kennedy, in retaliation for one of her people getting fired from Obi-Wan Kenobi, the writer, who's an NPC piece of shit, fired by Jon Favreau. You know, Leslie Headland was hired to develop The Acolyte. The Acolyte, just the whole idea, premise behind it, is stupid. It's basically a wham and dyke power bullshit show that shouldn't even be on Disney if Disney's actually a family company. And it's attached to the Story Group's greatest hits, The High Republic, the biggest failure in the history of Star Wars publishing. And it is basically the Soylo of Star Wars publishing. In fact, I think the only place now that they're actually putting out new High Republic stuff, and they're going to do it until they, that this run is over, and then that's it as far as I can tell. The only place you can get this garbage is at Walmart, and I'm pretty sure Walmart has a deal with Ollie's for a buyout, so expect within 2 to 3 years of seeing this shit on the shelves at Ollie's. So what is going on? So Variety announces that Lucasfilm is in talks to make, for an actress, and she's from The Hunger Games, a woman of color, I know, I hear people just going, rolling their eyes, named Amandla, because her name can't be Amanda, it's got to be Amandla Stenberg, to take the lead in The Acolyte. Talks. There's no substance to it. There's no serious, you know, but because it's Variety that put it out there, the various and sundry Fandom Menace channels, bleep, 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 and bleep, ran with it. And of course, the NPCs are dancing. This looks to me, after consulting people, that Leslie Headland put this out there and basically as maybe to force Disney to put it into production maybe before Iger left. But Iger's got, okay, it's the 9th of December. He's got 19 days left. I don't think her little idea will work. And really, she jumped the gun here with Bob Chapek. But again, Bob Chapek is still not getting any respect from the town. What the town has yet to realize is that Bob Chapek was picked by the stakeholders. Okay? And, excuse me, the stakeholders are sick and tired of not getting dividends, and they're sick and tired of Disney not being a for-profit company. But we all know what Chapek is up against, and it's not the town. It's the garbage this moron, Chairman Spendabuck, NPC enabler Bob Iger, put in to place at Disney. Buying of Fox, the buying of Lucasfilm, the fact that he allowed studio heads who aren't creative to run roughshod, and he and Alan Horn are leaving now. And who's replacing him? This woman, Susan Arnold, who comes over from the Carlyle Group. She's been on the board of directors of Disney since 2007. She is a person who the stakeholders want. Regardless of what you think about the stakeholders, this is a fantastic idea on their part. It basically gives Chapek free rein to fix what was broken. The only person he's got to answer to is her. And it looks to me that she and the stakeholders were the ones that chose Bob Chapek. And what else is going on at Disney? Which, when you look at this story about Amandla Stenberg being talked to about The Acolyte, makes it even more laughable is this. And really, the rise of Susan Arnold puts Kennedy into a position that she's never been in before. Susan Arnold, unlike Bob Iger, isn't a member of the club. Susan Arnold probably doesn't really know Kennedy, and Susan Arnold's only real responsibility is to the stakeholders and the shareholders. And whatever Kennedy thinks she's going to get out of this is probably not what she's going to get. In fact, I would say that when Susan Arnold, and I think the Susan Arnold, the advent of Susan Arnold began last year. It began a long time ago, probably before Chapek was even named. That Kennedy didn't see this coming. But Kennedy has bosses. She has to answer to the chairman of the studio head, which is the outgoing chairman of the studios, which is the outgoing Alan Horn, and to Bob Iger. That's all changing. Iger is now, I would say, he's got 1.5 feet out the door, okay? He's no longer interested in what's going on. And Alan Horn is gone. Her boss now, immediate boss, is this guy, Alan Bergman. He is the chairman of the studios. And he is very he was put there probably by Chapek, probably to fix what's wrong, what's broken. And he answers to Chapek. But so does Kennedy. Okay. The only person Chapek has to answer to is Arnold, and I'm pretty sure they're copacetic, they're on the same page. But despite what the fanboy rage porn addicts are saying about this whole Amandla Stenberg bullshit in Variety, it doesn't make any sense. If you go on to IMDb Pro, it doesn't make any sense. The only things we know that are happening for sure with Star Wars is the Favloni universe. And of course, WDW Pro said Favloni and Favreau have the movies too. So what does this mean? Does this idiot think that because Susan Arnold is a lesbian too, ugh, that's so gross, that she's got an ally in the new chairman of the board? Or was this retaliation for the rumors coming out that the Acolyte's going to be canceled? Okay. What is this? And she really doesn't understand that this woman is no longer the most powerful woman in Hollywood. Not that I think she ever was. And I think she actually lost her steam for sure, for reals, when Spielberg said, I've had enough of this shit, and walked away. You know, the whole thing, bros before hoes. And if the story about Lucas getting screwed over again by Kennedy again over the Rise of Skywalker filming is true, Spielberg walking away makes sense. So who is the most powerful woman in Hollywood? Introducing the soon-to-becoming chairman of the board of the Walt Disney Company, Susan Arnold, handpicked by the stakeholders to fix what is going on and wrong with the woke shit at Disney, because they want to make money. Money makes the world go round. She is the one behind Chapek. So this is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.